Cheeky Sunday. I just wanted to let you all know that the vlog's now up and you should go watch it. It's called Friends in Hockey. I get locked out of a building. I visit some friends in Vancouver. And then we do hockey. The hockey. This one. Like you're watching right now, keep watching it. Don't stop to watch, but like go back. Also watch this one is what I'm trying to get at. Welcome to the vlog.
Let's go look at them.
Okay.
A reputation for yourself now. Everybody knows that I feel left out. Girl, you got me down, you got me stressed out. Cause ever since I left the city, you started wearing less and going out more. Glasses of champagne out on the dance floor. Used to call me on the cell phone. Play now when you need my love. Call me on my cell phone. Play now when you need my love. I know when that hotline bling. That can only mean one thing.
Your homework because the drink means you're doing it. I can't even sit up with guilty. And you're here because you didn't have to.
A little bit of sound.
Thanks, James.
Adjust during sound.
What'd you adjust?
I just adjusted the height of the mic.
Is there a switch on the mic?
Yep. Oh, I just turned it off. That's all.
Hi internet. Hi mom, if you're watching this.
Why would your mom be watching my vlog?
Who doesn't watch your vlogs, James?
A lot of people. I get like tens of views.
Tens of views?
Tens of views.
How do you know my mom's not one of those views? She might be.
I don't know, that's a good point.
Half of the views on my radio show are my mom, so she's on that quest internet scene. And there's a fading yellow light. Rear view mirror. It's coming down in waves, drowning out the radio and the engines purr. The tires hold on to the pavement the way a floating piece of wood holds on to a river. With white lettering reads, no gas for 17 million miles. The dashboard calmly says it's all right, so the steering wheel falls asleep, and by the time it awakens, the skies opened up into a fireworks display. Tall silver buildings grow straight out of the scream. Welcome, congratulations. And downtown on a cloud top balcony, There's a guitar with a broken high knee string leaning on an empty chair. It's cold, but it's like that everywhere this time of year.
Enjoying your time right now?
The ISLM curve is fascinating. It has two lines, and it's going to solve our refugee crisis. So we're
going to
work on that.
Oh, I was very confused.
I did. Hey, Mar, how's it going?
Good, dude. What about you?
Good, good. What are you making me do right now?
Send my Irish dancing audition tape to the guys in Montreal.
What was that, Kimmy?
Kimmy isn't very happy.
That's not nice at all.
Yo, thank you, Kimmy.
You're so welcome.
Yeah.
When's it gonna be up?
Tomorrow night.
Yeah, great. So tens of viewers.
tens of viewers.
Be sure to go watch his video. I'll like link it tomorrow night.
Wait, what kind of?
I'll link it in tomorrow's vlog in like the corner. And this side. This side.
Yo, I'm gonna be shut up from James.
Tens of viewers. Thank you.
Ten.
Sorry, Kimmy. Could you do that again? Are you leaving?
Yeah. Or I'll take my name out. That's like the thing about the Google Doc.
You just delete it.
Yeah. That never happened.
Need a segue into talking about what the current policy situation is after employment.
Fuck.
And like what's happening
Which
in the future.
Yeah. No, I think that's legit.
Because then you can be like, and as you can see moving forward,
yeah. Okay.
There.
Sphere, here is the scoop. I am done. My presentation. It's only taken like 5 hours, and I did not get to do any of what I had wanted to tonight, which really, really sucks. Quick bite to eat, maybe look at a little bit more homework, and then, well, gosh golly, I'm gonna tell you a story. There, welcome home. It's story time now. Once upon a time, there was a young man named James. One time, James completely screwed up on Sunday night and planned his day terribly and was not able to do the story he promised. People generally hated him and regarded this as a pretty shitty move and a bad decision all around. James was sorry. James also thought that at 12 o'clock he should probably go to bed instead of telling a story that probably wouldn't be that good anyways. So he did that. James then also promptly decided that, hey, maybe I should
plan a story out at least like a week ahead. And then he started to do that. Also marked it in his calendar. Well, I hope you enjoyed the story of the week right there, but I screwed up. Sorry. I'm not actually that sorry. But it's been a slice today. So good night.